I know.
How do you feel right now? Did it sink in yet or not yet?
It's good, man. Feel good.
What about all the haters and disbelievers and?
That's all right. I mean,
they're still gonna be talking.
Gonna be talking. Yeah. That's all right. I mean,
still gonna be talking.
You need them too.
The ones that want to see you lose, the ones that want to see you win.
We still haven't done a good job, you know, for all those people.
Wait a second.
I think I'm gonna go home.
You're gonna go home?
No, I'm
gonna
go back.
Rapper, what does this championship mean to you?
It's great, man. You know, third division, three titles for Mikey, but this one really meant something. You know, because of the challenges, the weight division, bigger guys, it gave us that other great feeling. You know, the other two were like whatever, just like Mikey has said. But this one really meant something, man. This is awesome.
Mikey, do you remember when a TV network, and I'm not going to mention which one, said that the fans don't care about you? You remember that?
It's all right.
You remember that, Robert?
I'm trying to keep it down, though.
It's business, and you know, they, you know, sometimes promoters, sometimes TV networks make the wrong decisions, you know, stupid decisions, you know, but we're good now, we're happy, in control of Mike's career. What else do we need?
And what style, what a fashion.
Oh, incredible. Thank you very much, man.
Thank you, Connor.
You guys have a good night.
Thank you.
Ryu, did you see the fight? What did you think? What did you think?
Damn, brother, that was good, huh?
That's great! How'd you feel when you got that guy?
What's up, Rod?
Bero, what do you think?
Fucking easy knockout.
Nothing's easy.
What do you mean?
You got Rompek Kulis tonight on fire.
Who's that? Who's that?
Ryu.
Mikey, is this the band? Are these the band guys?
No.
Yeah. ¿Qué quieres que toque?
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekpak, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Eli Sekpak.
Look, Lua. Wow, is it Benzino?
Are they your neighbors, Robert?
No, they're my fighters.
How you doing?
Yeah. What are you talking about?
They look like they're in high school,
man. Ochoa and Brian Lua.
Okay.
They're both 1-0.
Congratulations.
They're from, see that? I train pro.
You train amateurs, pros, superstars,
yeah,
everybody.
That's what I like. That's, I love this shit.
Okay.
Well, look, the first thing, when his dad came in, the first thing says, when we seen that step that Mikey took, that's the same step that you trained these guys to do, you know, you step and then throw that right hand. And that's exactly what Mikey did. You know, my dad teaches that,
Christina said she saw him teach it at the gym.
Right, see?
I remember,
see?
I even
so,
had
so show me, show me how you guys do it.
See, watch. It's simple. See, yeah, look, in this case, the other guy was lefty, so it was
right.
But see, I pretend to go to the body, and these guys take a step that way, and then they come back with the right hand. It's perfect punch. It's even much better to throw it to a right-hander, because your target's right there.
So wait, one more time, Robert.
So I'm going to throw...
Okay.
Yes. I'm gonna throw my left to the body, but as soon as he sees me bend that way, he turns this way
and catches.
He throws it.
Yeah. That's it.
That's it. You avoid that left, and you're in an angle where you could land. When the guy turns at you, you land that.
Mikey,
that perfect right.
Mikey's uppercut put him out. He was out. He was. What's up, Tony? He was out on his feet from that uppercut.
So, primo, ¿cómo estás?
Bien, bien. Happy birthday, bro. Oh,
I stayed on the
high. Robert, you can get fucked up today. 18 and over. Here's a question. Are you going to train Chavez Jr. for the Canelo fight?
I don't know. That, I don't know.
I think after yesterday and after last, I told Mars that after Mars win and Mikey's win, he has to.
You know.
Be serious.
Look, be serious.
It'll
be a good thing.
It's just weird the way some fighters are. Some fighters think it's more important to have a conditioning coach than a boxing coach. Some fighters think that it's more important to be in the fucking mountains than to have a good trainer. I don't know. The results are there, you know. All my fighters, what we just did with Adam training in Riverside, what we did with Mikey training here in Riverside. But then there's other fighters that think, oh, we have to be in the mountains. The trainer has to come to the mountains. You know,
Hey, where were you at the fights? I didn't see you.
They're fighting this Friday. They couldn't go to the fight.
No, that's dedication right there. Because the old fighters would have made it to the fight.
Stay and rest. What's up, Jesse? Thanks, bro.
How you doing, Jesse?
Got a black guy?
Nah, it's just like that.
Nah, it looks like you have a black guy.
This one right here?
Yeah. Are you serious?
You're trying to look like Bam right now.
That's a lot of weight. Where's Bam?
He's coming on Wednesday.
Oh, I thought he was here already. Oh, okay.
Mikey, you just won. Talk about your win.
We're happy, man. We're excited. You know, it was a long time out of the rain. Now we're back. I told everybody. And now it's a third division world champion. I'm just super excited, man. I don't even have much words to explain or describe, you know?
Pio, what do you think?
Got that good belt. Strap season. Strap season. Great month. We start off the year with a great win, and I think Mike's on the basis, so hopefully by the end of the year we can get something like maybe knockout of the year or maybe even fighter of the year. You never know. We'll see.
And what's tomorrow?
Very happy with the win. He's nice and relaxed.
It's awesome. Mr. Vargas, what do you say? What do you say?
Fucking beautiful, man. Just like my compa said, Robert said, he goes, fucking belt, man, won that fucking belt, but, you know, won it against, Nonito Donaire, he got the belt, but it wasn't at his house. Now he fucking got to his house. That's fucking beautiful, man. So I'm happy for Mike, and Mike has to be the best fighter that my jefe, our jefe has made. Clean and simple.
Reporting.
Any good job,
Mikey.
Qué bien, Mario. Qué bonito.
Buena.
El cinto.
La casa, a dormir en la casa. Este no lo habíamos tenido.
El verde, es mexicano.
Verde.
Hey, we got to keep that room to a minimum until we done the test.
Like maybe 5 or 6. Yeah, 5 people. Once first 5 walks in, I'm shutting the door. 1, 2, 3.
That's it. That's good. Okay.
But Mikey, that was the best situation. You went in there, 2 rounds, 3rd one, take him out.
Do you want to see your punch next?
You hit him to the body, he didn't like it.
I hit him 2 times, good shots to the body, and you know, he showed me, and he, you know,
here,
his chest and
put it away,
out.
And then we'll see next week. Can you put it away somewhere?
Took a punch, but it was, you know, you're in the moment, so it's not like I was just landing, trying to go for the body. The opportunity would come, I would land a body shot, but I was landing the jab, you know, also, so.
What are you going to do about
running? I don't know. You and Crawford, what can we expect if that happens?
I think he's got something to, you know, worry about after this. I mean, it's obviously a good victory that he could consider, you know, a threat now. But if he's at 140 and I move up and he's still there, then, you know, we could sit on the top.
Pita, what did you think, Pita? Pita Fitness did a great job. Yeah. What did you think, Pita?
Fitness.
Did you love it?
Yeah, it was.
Were you nervous at all?
Put the hat on.
Did Pio cry in there?
Nah.
Not the, and the new.
The new.
Sophie made it.
That's very cool.
Where's the hat? So,
El perro. Big G, how did you like the fight yesterday?
Oh.
Good?
Perfect.
You know, Christina told me she saw you in the gym working on the same move with Mikey that he did for the knockout.
I have a video.
Es que ella me olvidó, que ella tiene un video donde estaba practicando el mismo pasito ese con Mikey en la derecha. En el gimnasio.
This move. Playing around.
Have you seen that movie with Tom Hanks?
Record that fucking dog.
Hopefully if he gets through, he's too tired to do anything.
What's he saying? Because of Southpaw? I think. What's he saying?
Mikey used his left elbow and controlled it on the outside to Mike's left. Avoided the left. Couldn't even throw it. That guy didn't even throw it.
Es que ese es el plan. Porque está pisándole al lado de afuera y intentándolo y escuchándolo un poquito. No puede tirar. Así es como se hace un plan. Quitarle el golpe más peligroso.
Big G, is Mikey right now one of the best pound for pound fighters? Best pound for pound champions?
Libra por libra, que si ahorita usted cree que Mikey es uno de los mejores.
Ah, pues eso, que lo diga luego la gente o la comisión. No me comenta. Yo sé que es bueno, pero.
He knows Mikey's good, but let the people say who, you know.
Okay.
Decide who pound for pound the best fighter is.
How about, is Robert the best trainer in the world right now?
Y mejor entrenador.
He's laughing. Okay. What?
Papa Garcia.
What do you wish Robert for his birthday today? He's 42 years old. Robert, what does he wish you for your birthday?
Que si que me desea para 42 años. Que cumpla mucho más,
¿eh? ¿Qué más quieres? Merecer dos triunfos, dos campeones mundiales en un mes.
He says, what else do you want? Two world champions in 1 month.
You know, when I do videos with you, Big G, a lot of people watch. Did you know you're very popular?
Que si usted se ha dado cuenta que es muy popular usted.
He doesn't know. He doesn't. He's not on YouTube or Facebook or Instagram.
Yeah, but Big G's popular.
He is popular. People love him.
Any video with him, like?
Yeah.
So Mikey looked great yesterday, and the face looked like he didn't fight yet. Great defense. Did he see it again? What did he see in the replay?
Very good work. Very nice.
Who would you want next? Do you want Crawford, Lomachenko, Pacquiao?
Bombón, here, take this to your mom.
Yo eso le he dicho a Mike. Quién sabe lo quiera hacer, pero yo he dicho que no vaya a retar a nadie personalmente. Es como ahorita, si reta al campeón de México, a Linares. Se oye mal que Mike.
Venezuela.
Pero se oye mal que Mike diga, quiero con él. Se oye mal.
Es como, Mike shouldn't be challenging anybody.
Como dicen, le tiene odio o envidia.
Mikey now is, in a position where they got to call him out.
That's true.
He doesn't want Mike to call anybody out. Al que quiera pelear con él.
Take this to your mom, I said.
Puede dar bonitas palabras diciendo que está disponible para quien quiera. Pero se oye más mal que rete a alguien. ¿Verdad?
Mikey, how many messages are you getting on your phone right now?
Man,
don't show us because I don't want to like.
It doesn't stop. But
what are people saying?
89 messages, 72 calls right now.
Is that brand new? 72 calls?
871 emails.
Wow.
It's
Now they love you.
And I've been asking. Look, now it's 90. And I've been answering these. It would have been probably about 150.
Already. What did they say?
Just congratulations and, you know, asking questions.
And the new.
Crazy.
How did it feel going out there, Mikey? How did you, like, just being back in title contention? Don't even second fight back in the champion right
now. It's great, man. Like I said, it's great. Look at him, he's all happy.
Who is he?
Number one fan. Hey,
that's how do you know? Number
hey, pinche Mikey, who was a good ass fucking
champion? Where's the cake? Where's the cake? Every time I won a title, hey, he would make me a cake.
Oh, no
every
cake?
Fight, every fight he gets a cake, but you know what? I had to support him this month. I had to support him at this fight. But you know what? We'll get a Carlos bakery cake tomorrow. That's what we'll get, big
guy. Hey, get some ceviche.
Orale! This fight, I couldn't get a cake.
A lot of people here, Mike.
Yeah, a lot of people, man. I had like 50 people from Austin. All these guys came down, like, told like 40, 50 people coming down.
This is the best part of the fight when you get to enjoy with everybody.
You know, that's what everybody wants to see. You know, we don't want to be here sad. You know, we're here, you know, cheerful. We're happy.
Thank you. The green belt, baby. That's the best part right there, man.
What went through your mind when Jimmy Lennon Jr. said, and the new? You're smiling.
I was happy, man. It's happiness.
You make it look easy, though, man. Yeah, you made it look too easy.
You want to spar him?
Nah, hell no, dude. I'm like, I'm 250 pounds and I'm scared of this guy.
He's far somebody. Who'd you spar, your friend?
The trumpet player.
You know, so he's also like 200 pounds.
That's a good one.
Mikey, what a night, huh?
Wonderful night. Couldn't be any better.
It's your coming out party. Huh. Robert, you were right. After tonight, everything changes.
Everything changes, man. I'm telling you.
Are you guys gonna wait?
It was awesome, man. It was great.
Are you guys gonna wait?
When the fighters, when our fighters listen and they follow instructions, there's the results. You know, I think what I do in my gym with my fighters, they all love training. They enjoy training. They want to come. They want to come back. They enjoy training camp. Mikey enjoyed training camp. Abner enjoyed training camp. That's the way we have to do it. You know, I know there's maybe other critics that say, oh, you know, they don't take it serious, but hey, but the results are there. So what else can we get? You know, two champions in less than 2 months with tough fights, very, very tough fights. I think it was, you know, the results, you know, they listen and they and the results are there.
Is Julio seriously
confident in that right hand? Everybody told me that you could see the expression in my face. And I didn't pay attention during the fight at that, but I saw the opening. I saw he was hurt, but he wasn't down, so I went for that overhand right. I knew I threw it, you know, with everything I had. But then when I saw the replay, you could definitely see that expression in my face, my eyes, and you know, I was like, you know, that surprised me even.
Who's next on your radar? Terry Flanagan?
Like I said, anybody at 135, you know, I'm willing to, you know, sit down, get those discussions and unify titles. I know they got their schedules and agendas also, so right now I'm gonna see what happens with their fights. But you know, I'm open to fight anybody.
Almost all your fights have ended in knockouts. And have you ever knocked someone out like that? Like, just thinking back?
I don't think never to this degree. I think this is the first time that happens. You know, it, like I said, I never wish any harm on my opponents. And I'm glad he was okay. I heard he just got released from the doctor and he was clear. That's good. So, you know, I wish him the best though.
But it was kind of weird the way, like, you hit him and he was clearly out, but he kind of, like, leaned up and then it seemed like he would have been better just to go down, but I don't think he knew where he was at.
The thing is that when you're in very good shape, you know, your body is reacting. Even when you're unconscious, you know, your body's reacting because your body's just naturally, you know, it's muscle memory. Mm-hmm. So his body was trying to react, but obviously his mind was unconscious.
Richard, is it safe to say that a star has returned to Ringstar Promotions?
A superstar. Not just a
superstar,
star,
yes.
A superstar. It's unbelievable. I mean, as I said before, the sky's the limit. I'm really convinced you're going to
Mikey has all the upside and all the potential to become truly the guy who carries the pay-per-view business going forward. You know, we were sort of like waiting. Everybody was like, who is going to be following into the footsteps of the great pay-per-view stars, you know, like Floyd Mayweather and so on. And we didn't really know. I mean, people said this guy or that guy. And we sort of like see all these bullshit pay-per-views going on now. This is the guy. You guys all know it. You all know it. The charisma, the skills, the personality, the marketability, the bilingual. I mean, just the bond that he came with. The bond that was great too. I mean, man, those guys were amazing.
What's the mando?
What do you want me to play? What do you want me to play?
I got the flute, dog. Got a saxophone too.
Oh, what's up, brother?
How's it going?
Hi.
Hello, hello.
Did you blink?
I blink. Excuse me.
How are you? Congratulations, man. Good for
you. Like, this is
no. Wow. No. What did you think?
Good!
All the hard work, everything paid off, Mikey?
Hard work pays off, you know?
That's fine. What does it mean to you, this one, versus the other others?
I keep telling you, it feels different this time. I'm not sure, I can't point out to one specific reason why, but it feels better this time, it feels nicer this time.
Millions and millions of people around the world are going to watch that knockout trezillion times. What, feel great?
No, it's not even about the knockout, it just feels good, you know? Good victory, good performance. A lot of people, maybe because of the time off, people were talking, and now I showed everybody, you know, what I can do, you know?
You're the real deal, Mikey. Pound for pound list. Official. I don't care. I always put you as pound for pound on my list. They're talking shit.
Here's the rounds, Ellie. Did you get a picture of them?
What did they have it as?
Ellie!
Come on, Ellie. Congratulations,
champions.
Big G.
Okay. I think I'm
going to
frame this.
Big G.
You accept that?
What?
Yes, sir.
Probably. I don't know. Probably.
Good.
But Mikey, that was the best situation. You went in there, two rounds, third one, take him out.
Do you want to see your punch touch?
You hit him to the body, he didn't like it.
I hit him two times, good shots to the body. And, you know, he showed me, you know,
here, keep
his chest and
put it away, and then we'll see next week. Can we put it away somewhere?
Took a punch, but it was, you know, during the moment, so it's not like I was just landing, trying to go for the body. The opportunity would come, I would land a body shot, but I was landing a jab, you know, also, so.
What are you going to do about it? I don't
know. You and Crawford, what can we expect if that happens?
I think he got something to, you know, worry about after this. I mean, it's obviously a good victory that he could consider, you know, a threat now. But if he's at 140 and I move up and he's still there, then, you know, we could...
Pita, what did you think, Pita? Pita Fitness did a great job. What did you think, Pita? Did you love it? Were you nervous at all?
Put the hat on.
Did Pio cry in there?
Nah.
Not the, and the new.
The new.
Sophie made it.
That's very cool.
Where's the hat? Is that
nice? All right, I'm out here. Congratulations. Hey, I'll see you next week.
Django.
Do
what?
Well, cooking.
Django. Hey. Oh, next week. Yeah, next week. Sunday or Saturday. I'll let you know. Yeah, we'll see.
Super Bowl?
Yeah, we'll do a Super Bowl.
They wanted for more.
They
didn't see them.
Yeah,
that's why I put the light.
I gave them two sweaters, so they're happy. Don't sell the drums. We'll have them make us a double, and they can buy it. Yeah, they could pay for it. All right, Mike, congratulations.
Mike, how do you feel? Champion again, bro?
I feel happy. I'm happier this time than I was before. You know, it just feels good, man.
See you guys later, man.
Like I said, the time off, all that, problem, drama, all that stuff. In the past, I can continue. I can show everybody, you know, they were missing. Prove some people wrong.
Is that the best part of it? You're able to show everybody?
A little bit. Some of it is.
I want to go try tacos and gordos, so I'm going to go with them.
Are you going to get effed up tonight to celebrate?
Maybe later in the night.
Tacos and gordos, that's a must.
Tacos and gordos.
And the news! I should go there too, man. I'm fucking hungry.
That's what I'm saying. We're going. We want to eat. Pita and all the guys. It's all Mike right there. It's all Mike right there. It'll be fun. It's Mike right there. I'm down, Mike. I'm not even drunk yet.
I don't care. I'm just hungry.
You want me to get you Big Mac?
Hey, I told Robert that Rafa actually did a great job. Rafa, congratulations. You got down.
I love you, bro.
He stayed.
Be a part of it, step for step, bro.
From the beginning to the end.
He was the first one to greet him at the back curtains. I'm going to get some tacos with guys. I'll meet you there before midnight.
Come to the Jewel at Aria. Dress code though, so.
You gotta change. Hey, but I did everything. You walking in the ring, you were happy. When you look genuinely happy.
I was happier this time than I was there before. Like I said, the first time I won it was like, okay, whatever. Second time, okay, not a big deal. But for some reason, this one is special.
Mikey, how many messages are you getting on your phone right now?
Man,
don't show us, because I don't want to, like...
It doesn't stop. But
just what are people saying?
89 messages, 72 calls right now.
Is that brand new? 72 calls?
871 emails.
Wow. Now they love you.
And I've been asking. Look, now it's 90. And I've been answering these. It would have been probably about 150.
What did they say?
Congratulations, and, you know, asking questions. And, just, yeah.
And the new.
It's crazy.
How did it feel going out there, Mikey? How did it feel, like, just being back in title contention? Only your second fight back of a champion already.
It's great, man. Like I said, it's great. You know, look at him. He's all happy.
Who is it?
Number one fan.
Hey, that's
how do you know? Number
one. Hey, pinche Mikey.
Mikey.
Where's the king?
Every time I won a title, he would make me a cake.
Oh, no
cake? Every fight, he gets a cake. But you know what? I had to support him at this fight. But you know what? We'll get a Carlos bakery cake tomorrow. That's what we'll get, baby.
Hey, get some ceviche.
Morale! This fight, I couldn't get a cake.
A lot of people in your mind.
Yeah, a lot of people, man. I had like 50 people from Montreal. All these guys came down. Like, total like 40, 50 people coming down.
Is this the best part of the fight when you get to enjoy with everybody?
That's what everybody wants to see. You know, we don't want to be here sad. We're here, cheerful. We're happy.
Thank you. The green belt, baby. That's fun right there, man.
What went through your mind when Jimmy Lennon Jr. said, and the news?
Hey, gotta keep it on crying, dog.
You're smiling.
I was happy, man.
Hey, you make it look easy, though, man. Yeah, you made it look too easy.
You want to spar him?
Nah, hell no, dude. I'm like, I'm 250 pounds, and I'm scared of this guy.
He's Marshall, but what'd you spar, your friend?
The trumpet player.
He's also like 200 pounds.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Secback.